Iron Man. You guys know why, right? Didn't you see it in the paper?
No.
Hey, see, later today, I'm going to try out to be a representative for the state of Tennessee in the National Iron Man competition.
You're going to
awesome.
Be an Iron
Check
Man competition.
Check out these digs, man. I'm going to smoke the competition.
You're going to be an Iron Man competition.
Why, yeah, man. Why not?
Oh,
this
so
is
you're
great.
So you're going to go
you
in there.
You guys think I'll win?
Listen, Mitchell, you're going to go in there and you're going to do a 2.4-mile swim.
Absolutely. Michael Phelps, here I come.
Oh, and then you're going to turn around and you're going to do a 112-mile bike ride?
Yes, I am. 112 miles?
That's exactly
really?
Right. A 112-mile bike ride. Then you're going to run a 26.4-mile run?
Well, I was, but you see, there's one slight problem this morning.
Oh, there's a slight problem. What is that problem?
My lucky gym bag. I don't see it.
Your lucky gym bag.
Do you guys see my lucky gym bag anywhere? Nobody see my lucky gym bag. I didn't even give him a chance to answer.
So you're telling
There's
me
no
if you had
bag.
Your lucky gym bag, you would do the
see,
Ironman
dude,
competition.
See, here's the thing. My lucky gym bag has my favorite super fast Speedo swim shorts in them. It has my super fast Lance Armstrong helmet, which I'll have to swap out, you know, for this one. And it has my awesome chrome blue alligator running shoes. Faster than Usain Bolt.
Okay, wait a minute.
And
so you're telling me.
As you can see, no bag.
No, Mitchell.
No competition.
You're telling me that if you had this gym bag, this lucky bag full of your stuff, that you would actually do the Ironman competition?
Absolutely. I would do it if I had my lucky gym bag.
Okay, why don't you go over there and say the virtue for me one more time.
Guys, say it with me. Everybody in the KidStuf house, say it with me. Determination. Deciding it's worth it to finish what you've started.
So you're telling me.
We've got it, okay?
Using our virtue.
Next month.
That if you had your gym bag, that you would do the Ironman competition through the grueling pain with your muscles aching and spazzing out, that you would actually do this Ironman competition.
Let me tell you something, Rick. Wild ferrets could not drag me away if I had my gym bag. But as you can see, no gym bag, no competition. Whoa, glad that didn't hit anybody. So, what's that say?
Mitchell, I believe this is your bag.
Like, I'm the only Mitchell in Tennessee. We all know that's someone else's gym bag.
Let's just find out.
Okay, well, let's see. What you got in there? Oh. My lucky swimsuit. Who's that? That's my lucky swimsuit. So there's see the flames? Those are real flames, man. I'll take that. Thank you. And no way! Check it out, man, my blue chrome and blue alligator shoes. These are awesome. Look, I'm glad you found my gym bag. Still one problem, though.
Nope, no problem. We got your gym bag.
Nope.
We got to go get you signed up.
There's the
whole
shoes. Hangnail thing.
Oh, no. Uh-oh. Mitchell, wild ferrets.
And you know, I mean, come on.
Wild ferrets!
We're not going to go through this, are we?
Oh, yes. Wild ferrets.
He's a cool exec with a heart of steel.
An Iron Man, all jets ablaze. He's fighting and smiting with repulsor rays. Amazing armor.
Yes, Iron Man.
A blazing bomber.
Go south.
I can't. I lost my lightning gun. Can't get over the wall.
Yeah, I'll go around to the tower and unlock it from the inside.
We've almost got it. This is so awesome.
I know, man. This is the coolest thing ever.
Hey, guys. Anybody seen Cammy? Boys.
Hey, Grandpa Henry.
Oh, man. I haven't had a gritty that exciting since I put back on Aunt Pearl's denture cream. But anyway, if you guys see Cammy, I need to talk to her about this fundraiser that she's heading up here. I'm afraid it's not very good news either. See you later, guys.
Oh, yeah.
Hey, Grandpa Henry.
Sweet niblets.
Grandpa Henry, I'm so glad you're here. I just heard from the mayor's office we're going to get TV coverage on the first annual Tri-Trigon Athlon. It's really going to put the awareness out there. Aren't you so excited? You're not smiling. What's wrong?
Well, no, I think it's great about the TV and all that, Cammy. It's just that I've got something I got to tell you.
Okay, this is starting to sound really bad already. Just tell me now before I have to start breathing into a bag.
Okay, just calm down. Take some deep breaths. Now, it's just that ever since you changed it from a normal triathlon ever since you modified it from a normal triathlon, it just seems that the teams that do normals, they don't want to be a part of this.
So some of the teams are just canceling the day before the event.
Well, yeah.
Okay, even that team from Kansas?
Dust in the wind.
The team from Florida?
Retired.
Hawaii?
They said aloha.
Texas?
You messed with them.
Oh, okay. What about that team that wanted us to buy new equipment?
New jerseys?
Yeah.
Oh, well, you know, just like the rest of them, they just quit.
But why? I mean, who wants to watch that same old run, bike, swim thing? Not when you can watch something that everyone enjoys watching. And I have a ton of publicity lined up, too.
But, Cammy, these teams are trained to do a normal triathlon, not a...
Try-try-again athlon?
Yeah, you can say that again. But don't. Look, Cammy, you've really, really tried hard. You've put your best foot forward, you know, but maybe it's time to unsaddle that horse.
What? Grandpa Henry, this whole thing is about not giving up. The Children's Hospital hasn't given up on me, and I'm sure not giving up on all those kids.
Cammy, but the event is tomorrow. Where are you going to find? You don't even have a single team lined up yet.
I know.
You know, we're getting down to the last minute here, and where in the world would you find two guys who have nothing but time on their hands, two guys that don't give a fig newton about their self-esteem? You know, they're ready to sacrifice their body, their mind, their soul. They've never trained for triathlon, but...
Dude, I got the pineapple power bar.
Yeah, I know.
Hey, guys.
Oh, hey, Cammy, we're playing the game. Don't bother me.
Guys, what if I told you that you could redeem yourselves from hours of your life wasted on video games?
Oh, hey, Cammy, don't bother me.
Hey, guys, wait a minute. Why don't you pause those gizmos there? I think Cammy has something to tell you.
Do what? Okay, Grandpa. All right, Vinny, on three. One, two, three, mark.
Impressive. I didn't know you guys worked so well as a team.
We are the War Zingers 3 champions.
War Zingers 3, Revenge of the Junk Food.
Wow. As exciting as that sounds, why don't you two put your skills to use in other ways?
Other ways? Like what other ways?
Like a different kind of game.
Really?
Yeah, but you guys probably aren't up to the challenge.
Whoa, she is good.
Wait a second. Me and Vinny, we're up to any challenge you can throw at us.
Yeah, we just can't take a hint.
So, what is this new challenge game thingy?
It's a try-try-again athlon.
A triathlon? I've always wanted to try one of those.
Roger, we've got to do this. But Vinny, we don't even know what she's talking about yet. We can't just, like,
wait. Wait a minute, guys. This is not a normal triathlon. Cammy's changed everything around there. And the team that wins this is going to pass a true test of determination.
Did you hear that, Roger? We've got to do this. We've got to show the world what teamwork we have. Just think about it. Even the word triathlon has the word try in it. And then you've got athlon. I'm pretty sure that means something, too.
Vinny, I just don't know. I really don't like to perspire.
Yeah. I mean, it's okay, guys. Listen, I'll just tell the hospital that I asked you guys, but then you quit before you even started. Vinny and Roger, quitters.
Quit. Uh-oh. That tears it. Ever since Roger was a little boy, he didn't like anybody telling him he was a quitter.
Well, you know, Roger, there's only one way to stop this. Cammy, you can count us in. We're a lean, mean, try again machine. Right, Roger?
Right.
All right, Roger, come on. Let's go get ready for this. Awesome.
I'm so dead.
Cammy, you knew what you were doing all along, didn't you?
Maybe. After all, I did invent the try again athlon.
All right, we're going to play a game called Those Aren't the Lyrics. Now, here's how it works. I'm going to pull a contestant from the audience. Anybody who wants to come up here and get totally embarrassed in front of your peers, we're ready for you. Now, here's what's going to happen. Oh, kids, you're not allowed, hands down. This is totally for the parents. We're going to wear them out this morning a little bit. So here's what I'm going to do. We're going to sing a song, and the song's going to start. You've got to sing along a little bit with the song, and then the words are going to stop. You have to complete it. Sound easy enough? I need some volunteers. Who's ready to come up and, yes sir, in the red, come on up. Give him a hand.
Check, check.
Right. Thank you, sir.
Your name is?
Blaine.
Blaine, look at everybody here. They're gonna laugh at you. They're gonna be glad for you. All right, now, Blaine.
How old are you, Blaine?
29.
So you kind of grew up in the 80s, didn't you? Towards the end of the 80s a little bit? All right, so what we're thinking today, I'm thinking movie themes from the 1980s. How many of you guys like 80s music? All right. And our virtue is? Think 80s music and determination. Now, here's how it works. We're going to start a song. You can hold this mic. You've got to sing the words. Excellent. You got to sing the words to the song. Now, at some point, the song's going to stop. Okay. And I need you to finish the last 11 words. Are you up for the task?
Are you going to put them on the screen?
Absolutely. Absolutely. But now the words you have to fill in, you got to know them. Okay. It's a game show. All right. Are you guys ready? You can sing along if you need to help him out. Hit it, guys. Give him a hand, Blaine. Thank you, sir. That is determination. All right, next contestant, please. I got another one. Next contestant, look at them back there. Okay, wait a minute. I think I've got a contestant in my head because I saw an old KidStuf dancer that used to be a part of the team, and now she's gone off to get edumacated. Jackie Pickle, come on up here. All right, for this song, all right, Jackie, I know you're not old enough to, do you know who Sly Stallone is?
No.
Doesn't even know who Stallone. You're going to struggle here. Jackie, tell them what your name is.
Jackie
Pickle. We all knew that. I've been saying it for the next 10 minutes. Jackie used to be a KidStuf dancer, and then she wanted to go get edumacated somewhere, and so she was going to do that. I've got Revolution. You guys going to help me out on this one?
Yeah.
Revolution, come on up. Where you at? Come on up. Lake Forest. All right. You guys ready? Okay, you ready? Now we're going to sing some words. You're going to get to start, and then the last part of the song, you got to fill in the blank and sing the words. Guys, help her out because she's too young to know the words of this song. Are you ready? Determination, Sylvester Stallone, hit it.
Yeah, let's go. We got this.
You think you know the words?
No, I don't.
Here we go.
I was a dancer, not a singer.
Oh, yeah, that's right. Here we go. Sing it.
And it's will to survive in this
Thank you, Jackie. Guys, in case you haven't figured it out yet today, I'm glad everybody's here, but you know, if the pastor's away at Talladega and your kids' program sings the Eye of the Tiger, you might go to a redneck church. Next contestant. Next contestant. 1970s music. You gotta be kidding me. Where did you guys come from?
First of all,
I wondered what was yapping along going on there. Hey guys, you better clear some space out here. You better clear some space out here. Oh my goodness, the stage awaits you, prima donna, Miss Samara. You guys could interrupt the playground. Okay, all right. I'm glad you guys.
We want to play this game. We want to be right. I can't believe you're having a 200 episode, and we are not a part of this.
I'm sorry.
Sorry is not the word.
Well, you made yourself a part.
Yeah. Well, we had to.
What's the virtue of this month?
Determination.
Guys, what's the virtue? Say it with them. Determination. Deciding it's worth it. Okay, so why don't you guys finish what I started?
Okay.
All right, 1970s music, 72 to be exact, and I know you guys were around then. You ready?
Yeah. Sure. Yeah.
Go.
This is our song, by the way.
I'm a woman, hear me roar, in numbers too big to ignore. And I know too much to go back.
Ain't no pretend in here.
Cause I've heard it all before, and I've been down there on the floor. No one's ever gonna keep me down again.
And they brought the house down.
Oh, yes, I want, but it's wisdom for the pain. Oh, yes, I pay the price. Oh, but look how much I've gained. If I have to, I can do anything. I am strong, so I am invincible.
If we're tired,
sing it.
I am woman.
Get off the stage. 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 Hey guys, thanks for playing. Those are lyrics all about determination. Dancers, come on, everybody stand up. We're gonna worship and again. I wanna hear you singing.
I love you, Lord. I worship you. I love you, Lord, always.
Just take a good look today.
Whoa, chairs in my way. Hey guys, how's it going? What are you playing Crazy Carl's music for? I'm not Crazy Carl. Man, anyway, hey guys, say hey.
It's okay. It's all
right. Woo, there's a whole lot of people here. It should actually be louder than that. Hey!
Hey!
Yes, I love that. Man, let's do that every Sunday. Hey guys, we're talking about what?
Determination.
And you guys learned good. We're talking about determination this month, and there's a whole lot of people out here right now. And there's a whole lot of jobs, different jobs that people do. And I want to ask all you guys out here, when I say determination, what kind of jobs do you guys think about? What kind of jobs require determination? Somebody tell me some. What was it? Air medic? I'm sure that one does, yeah?
Yeah, that's good. That's a good job.
That's a good, I don't know where you came up with that, but good one. Good. Air medic. Is he flying around in the air? If somebody gets hurt in the air, they go and they help him. What's up, Elise? You got one? Teaching. Yes. Yes, I was a teacher. We're so determined.
I was like,
to love you guys, make you smarter. Get smart. Oh, hello.
Hey, let it start.
How are you doing?
It's been fine. It's been good.
Yes, you guys are smart, man. You guys have really been thinking about this. You guys impressed me. Okay, what else? What's another one? Police officer, yes, determined to make this a safe place for us. Fire truck guy, person on a fire truck. Ambulance person, and not in the air either. Yes, you guys are good. I'm very impressed. You guys have impressed me. So today we're going to talk about determination, guys. And in that, we are going to talk about Paul and what Paul did. Carl, I'm doing something.
What's going on out here? You guys out here pooping and hollering and screaming, waking up the whole neighborhood.
That's why they were playing your music before, man.
Well, yes.
Yeah, that because you had to come out and mess this up. I mean, hey, Carl. Sorry, man. We didn't mean to disturb you, buddy. But I was out here and I was going to talk to the kids about Paul and determination. You know,
so you guys
and we
were
talking
here.
About
whoa,
jobs.
Whoa. You guys are out here talking about all these.